Good morning. On behalf of Sheriff Ken Tregoning and the men and women of the Carroll County Sheriff's Office, thank you for joining us this morning in recognizing the individual values and actions that highlight the ideals of the law enforcement profession. In recognition of this significance, we're also joined by some honored and distinguished guests. Carroll County Sheriff Ken Tregoning, Howard County Police Chief Bill McMahon, Delegate Susan Krebs, Commissioner Doug Howard, and Commissioner Richard Rothschild. Thank you, distinguished guests, for joining us this morning. Also, please join me in welcoming the Director of Support Services with the Maryland Police Training Commission and a former major retired from the University of Maryland Police Department, the Reverend Father James Hamrick, who will lead us in an invocation this morning. Reverend Hamrick.
If you would please stand. Oh Lord, we acknowledge that in you we live and move and have our being, that you are the source and fountainhead of all that is good and true and beautiful. And Lord, as we come together today for this celebration, we give you thanks, Lord, for our public safety professionals who put their lives in harm's way each day in protection of our community. And Lord, as we come to specially recognize the meritorious and service and valor of these two brave men, we just pray your blessing upon them. We ask that you uphold them in all that they do. We thank you for the support of their families and for the support of their agencies. And we ask you to be continually present in their lives and the lives of all those who give themselves in service to you and to your community. We also pray for the victim in this case who continues to recover from her injuries. We ask that you continue to heal her and uphold her. We just thank you for all that you are and for all that we are in you. For we ask all this in thy holy name. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Father. And please remain standing and join us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated. This morning, we will recognize two law enforcement officers with the Carroll County Sheriff's Office highest award, the Medal of Valor. Recipients of this award have distinguished themselves, demonstrating courage and bravery in the face of great personal risk while protecting or saving a life. Sheriff Tregoning and Chief McMahon will assist in presenting this award and be joined by the law enforcement officers that we will recognize when their name is called. The Carroll County Sheriff's Office recognizes Howard County Police Corporal Craig Green. The Carroll County Sheriff's Office recognizes Carroll County Sheriff's Corporal William Gunner Burke. On January 11th, while traveling through Carroll County off duty on Route 97, just below Morgan Run, Corporal Ream of the Howard County Police Department observed a serious accident involving an overturned burning vehicle that had left the roadway. Immediately, Corporal Ream ran to the burning vehicle and observed a critically injured woman who was screaming and suffering from agonizing pain. Corporal Ream worked to free the woman, Casey Marie Belafado, from the overturned burning vehicle. He was joined by Corporal Gunner Burt of the Sheriff's Office, who'd responded to the accident from nearby where he was patrolling. As Corporal Burt approached the vehicle, he heard the cries of pain from Casey and rushed to help Corporal Ream remove her from the overturned burning vehicle where she'd been trapped. Together, Corporals Ream and Burt were able to free Casey from the inferno and administer first aid until the paramedics arrived. It was their spontaneous actions, the selfless action of Corporals Ream and Burt, without regard to their own personal safety, that they saved the life of a serious accident victim who had suffered serious trauma, including severe burns. Corporals Ream and Burt's bravery and humane compassion was above and beyond the call of duty and is a credit to themselves, their agencies, and the law enforcement profession. Please join me in recognizing the two corporals. I would ask each chief executive to present their corporal with the award of valor. On behalf of the citizens of Carroll County and the Maryland House of Delegates, I welcome Delegate Susan Krebs. Please remain standing, gentlemen.
Thank you. It's really an honor and a privilege to be here today. And we're celebrating these two gentlemen that have gone above and beyond the call of duty. But we all know that they represent many of their own law enforcement officers, that they're always available and they're always ready and willing to go above and beyond the call of duty. But we want to make sure we take this special time to honor this. And it was very interesting. I was reading the article about the situation. And the police chief, Mr. Mahan, said in a statement that he couldn't be more proud to hear the word hero used all the time. But Craig's actions this morning were truly heroic. And Mr. Ream said, "I don't feel I'm a hero. I feel I did something any police officer would do. I did what I had to do." And Mr. Mahan gave him accolades. But both of these gentlemen did what anyone else would do. They risked their lives, and you all sitting here in the audience, your family members, your friends, and when you send them off in the, every day, you don't know what's going to happen, whether it's going to be a calm day, whether it's going to be a heroic day, or whether it's going to be a day that there's even a greater sacrifice. So we just appreciate our law enforcement officers and are here to recognize that you are willing to go above and beyond every single day when you walk out the door and go to work. So I have with me here today resolutions from the Maryland House of Delegates, and I will read them to you. Be it hereby known to all that the House of Delegates of Maryland offers its sincerest congratulations, first to Corporal Craig Ream, in recognition of your courage, heroic action, and valor during the rescue of Casey Marie Belafato. The entire membership extends best wishes on this memorable occasion and directs this resolution to be presented on this 11th day of January, 2013. That was the day of the accident. And it's signed by the Speaker of the House, Mike Bush, and all four of the Carroll County House of Delegates members, Delegates Justin Reedy, Delegates Don Elliott, Delegate Nancy Stocksdale, and myself. And we have one for Corporal Ream, and we have the same resolution for Corporal Burt. And I thank you both very, very much. something?
On behalf of the Board of Carroll County Commissioners, please join me in welcoming Board President Commissioner Doug Howard.
Well, good morning. I'm also pleased to be joined today by Commissioner Richard Rothschild from District 4. Carroll County is a blessed community, and it is so wonderful to see the heroic actions of someone from a neighboring jurisdiction and one of our own. And we talk a lot about what strengthens our community, things like public safety and infrastructure and education. And today, we celebrate the heroic actions that have made Carroll County stronger and prouder and more ready for the future and the challenges that we face. So we thank those that are being awarded today for their tremendous, tremendous sacrifice, their willingness to put others before themselves, and the agencies that we represent, or that they represent, that we're so fortunate to have as part of our community. So we have two proclamations. The first for Corporal Ream. It says, whereas, despite significant danger to himself, Police Corporal Craig Ream, an 11-year veteran of the Howard County Police Department, spotted a burning building on his way into work on January 11, 2013. Whereas Corporal Craig Ream attempted to use his fire extinguisher to put out the automobile fire with little success, whereas Corporal Craig Ream crawled under the hood of a burning car, squeezed himself through a small opening to free a teenage woman from the wreck, pulling her out of the car and up a hill. Whereas Corporal Craig Ream, without regard for his own safety, acted quickly to save a young woman's life. Now, therefore, we, the Board of Carroll County Commissioners, do hereby recognize Corporal Craig Ream for his amazing courage and true heroics during this incident, adopted the 25th day of February 2013, signed by the Board of Commissioners. Congratulations.
Thank you, Commissioner. We also have a proclamation for Corporal Gunner Burt that I'd like to read to everyone. Whereas Corporal Gunner Burt of the Carroll County Sheriff's Office responded to an accident on January 11, 2013 with a vehicle engulfed in flames down a steep embankment. And whereas Corporal Gunner Burt aided in extricating an injured female from the burning vehicle. And whereas Corporal Gunner Burt began administering first aid procedures on the victim until the medics arrived. And whereas Corporal Gunner Burt, without concern for his own safety, acted selflessly to save this young woman's life. Now, therefore, we, the Board of Carroll County Commissioners, do hereby recognize Corporal Gunner Burt for his incredible bravery and humane compassion during this occurrence, adopted this 25th day of February, 2013.
To remain standing for a little while. First of all, I'd like to, everyone be seated, please. I would like all the family members of the Bellafato family to stand up and be recognized, please. Thank you. And the family members of Corporal Ream and Corporal Burke. If they're in attendance, could you stand and be recognized? Thank you. Obviously, we have two exceptional police officers standing before you. They've taken an oath to defend and protect, and they're willing to give their lives to do that. We owe you everything. Thank you.
I'll just be very brief. I guess two points, one the delegate made. You know, when I was first told about this incident, you know, this is right in the middle of football season, the playoffs, everybody's excited and talk about heroes. I don't think NFL players or NBA players are heroes. I think heroes are among us. I think they're not recognized for the everyday sacrifices they make. You know, these two gentlemen are what law enforcement professionals are about throughout both our counties and throughout this region, throughout the state. And I am certainly proud to be among them and to be here today to see them get the recognition they deserve. And I guess the other amazing part for me on this, certainly the actions, but kind of the unawareness that they had that they had did anything heroic that morning. I heard stories from both that I think in Corporal Burt's case, didn't even tell anybody, he kind of found about it secondhand, the supervisors did. And for Craig's case, again, you know, he wasn't calling and telling anybody. We learned about this, and when you recognize them, like, yeah, but I was just doing my job. I appreciate the recognition, but you know, this is just what we do. I think that's, you know, what heroes are in our society. So thank you to the family. Our prayers, our thoughts are with you as your daughter continues her recovery. I know it's difficult, but I know it could have been much worse as well. So, again, thank you for letting us come up and be part of this celebration today. Thank you, Sheriff.
This is a little public service announcement. For those of you who don't know, you're sitting in a new facility that just opened a couple of weeks ago, and we are so proud of it. 3 years ago, we had a catastrophic snowstorm that collapsed the ceiling of the hall here and caused a huge fire, and our hall burned down. And our community has been a void of having this community place to gather. And it's just opened a couple of weeks ago. We're not even officially open. And we have a lot of heroes that belong to the Sykesville Freedom District Fire Department. A lot of them are standing around. They're our volunteers. Our volunteers are what drive our fire departments in Carroll County. And I'm just here to mention we're just trying to get geared back up again to start having this be our community center. We had an event a couple of weeks ago. We had an Elvis impersonator right here on this stage, and it was really fun. And this week we're having an Irish rock band called Barley Juice. They're supposed to be one of the top Irish rock bands around. It's supposed to be real fun. It's corned beef and cabbage for St. Patrick's Day. And I'm just trying to get everybody enthusiastic to come back and support our fire department and our volunteer men and women here, because they've done a phenomenal job of rebuilding this facility, but it had a huge price tag, and our community now needs to step up and help support our volunteers and our fire department. So if you want any information about that event and ongoing events for this district, this fire department, you can get online at the Sykesville Fire Department, www.sykesvillefire.org. I've got 25 people coming this weekend for, it's my date to my husband for St. Patrick's Day, and it's going to be corned beef and cabbage, all included for $25. So if you're interested, you can pick up a little form, and please support our local volunteer fire departments all around our county and also in Howard. So thank you very much.
In closing, we'd like to acknowledge the work of the Sykesville Freedom District Fire Department and the Women's Auxiliary in hosting this morning's presentation. I'd also like to recognize Ms. Roberta Windham and Mr. Chris Swam from the Board of Carroll County Commissioner's Staff, and Ms. Linda Lyons and Ms. Sue Homan from the Carroll County Sheriff's Office in helping us prepare this morning's presentation. Please join me with one final round of applause for our distinguished guest, the volunteers, and our heroes. And anyone that would like pictures, gentlemen, if you would, please join us up here, and you're free to gather pictures. Everyone will be here. Thank you.